And there were two. Eastleigh from the Blue Square South, AFC Totton from the Evo Stick Premier. Hampshire supremacy is at stake. Who will win Hampshire's most prestigious prize? Hello and welcome to a special Win All Sports Week. AFC Totton may have won the Hampshire Senior Cup two seasons running, but Eastleigh are vying to stop it by securing their first cup victory in this competition. It's Hampshire Senior Cup final time. Of course, here on Win All, I won't be doing this all by myself. I'm delighted to be joined by sports reporter and news anchor Jake Gable. Now, Jake has reported on both AFC Totton and Eastleigh over the last two seasons, and I'm sure his knowledge and expertise will no doubt enlighten us all. A very good day to you, Jake.
Thank you, Aaron.
Let's talk about this. Two great teams, non-league teams in Hampshire, vying out for a piece of silverware. You couldn't ask much more than this, really, could you?
No, absolutely. I'm sure we're in for a game of great entertainment. Aaron, you know, both teams really going for this. It's their chance for silverware this season, and I'm sure we're going to be up for quite a game.
OK, well, AFC Totton are chasing their third consecutive title, and what a better place to do it than against their local rivals. Now, Totton booked their place by beating Havant and Waterlooville in the semi-finals. Henry Lewin Titt watched this epic encounter unfold.
AFC Totton played Havant and Waterlooville in the semi-final of the Hampshire Senior Cup, with the current cup holders, the Stags, trying to make it three finals in as many years. Havant started off on the front foot and could have taken the lead if it wasn't for a triple save from Grant Porter keeping the scores level. Totton had a long-range effort at goal, but it didn't trouble the keeper. Havant had the best chance to open the scoring, but were denied by the post. Early in the second half, Havant thought they had taken the lead, but the assistant referee ruled the player offside. 16-year-old Jack Odam poked home a half volley from range to give Totton the lead. Ollie Palmer beat the Totten defence to a low cross to even the scores for the home team. With the game looking like it could go into extra time, a mistake from Beasley in goal let Ryan Moss scramble in a winner for the Stags. This win sees Totten marching through to a third final in a row, hoping to make it a hat-trick of cup wins. Henry Lewin-Titt, Winchester News Online.
So AFC Totton beating Havant and Waterlooville there, and of course it was a fantastic game, wasn't it? Jack Odam, the 16-year-old, scoring the winning goal, brilliant goal. But what was your thought on the game?
Well, I think AFC Totton outclassed their opponents overall. I think if you look at the two teams, you know, their golfing ability showed come the end. Totton had a lot of possession, a lot of chances, and I think really they just made their ability tell there in the end, Aaron, and they deserve winners. And they go through to the final now, and we'll be looking really to progress and win this competition for the third year in a row.
AFC Totton may have won it twice on the bounce, but Eastleigh are playing in their first ever Hampshire Senior Cup final, and they managed the feat by beating Winchester City at the Demplan City Ground in their semi-final. I went down to the Silver Lake Stadium to meet a very optimistic manager in Ian Baird and his thoughts on the final.
Well, the hardest game is when initially when we played Aldershot. Aldershot had all their first team squad players and some of their first team players, and we got beaten that game, so we were effectively out of the tournament. We had an extremely young side that night, but for them playing a player that was ineligible, so it managed us to get back in. The semi-final against Winchester was a local derby. They, for one, were desperate to beat us, we know that, and we were desperate to beat them, so there was a bit of an edge on that game, and we shaded it with a penalty from Jamie Slabber, who unfortunately is no longer with us. So we were a little bit fortunate because on the night it could have gone either way. But, you know, we're in the final now and we'll be doing our best to try and beat Totton. Yeah. Well, I mean, we've still got the likes of Damien Scannell, we've got Lee Peacock, we've got Tom Jordan, Gary Elphick, Andy Forbes, Mitchell Nelson, Michael Green, you know, Gareth Barfoot. You know, every player's a big player, and, you know, to play at St Mary's will be the pinnacle for the season for us. Being in a cup final, playing against EC, local rivalry, and playing at St Mary's will, I think, the loss, you know, the pain of losing in the playoffs will be quickly forgotten, and they'll be wanting to put on a show because you're playing at a tremendous stadium. There'll be a lot of people there, and they won't want to let themselves down. That's for sure.
And sum up in a sentence what it would mean for you personally winning the cup.
It would be very, very nice.
So that was Ian Baird there, and he sounded very optimistic, didn't he?
You know. Absolutely.
Of course, making reference to the fact that AFC Totton lost in their playoffs, but he was pretty sure in his response that they will be out to beat them in the final.
Well, I think Ian's got, you know, great confidence in his players, and I think that's a fantastic thing for the players to know that their manager has that faith in them and their ability. He'll be expecting them to go out and really bring this trophy home for the supporters. And, you know, up against Totton, it's going to be a tight game, but they have to remember they are a division above their opponents, and I'm sure if they play as he would like them to, they can go out and get their hands on this trophy.
Yeah, well, there you go. Well, this game could not have gone ahead without the superior work of both Southampton Football Club and the Hampshire Football Association. With goal line technology featuring at St Mary's for the first time, I caught up with someone who knows a little more about this competition than myself. Here we are. I'm joined by Dan Berry, the business support officer for Hampshire FA. Now, Dan, here she is.
Absolutely.
Magnificent trophy. The first question I've got to ask you is, how significant is this cup to Hampshire?
Well, it's just a cup as any other cup is, but what it represents is, you know, truly significant. The Hampshire FA Senior Cup Final is our prestigious cup final. It's the showpiece event for non-league football in Hampshire, so this means quite a lot to a lot of non-league footballers.
Yeah, and obviously this year in itself is going to be pretty significant because obviously goal line technology will be entering the fray for the very first time ever.
Yeah.
And of course, you being a very busy man at Hampshire FA, I'm sure you've had to deal with the world's media.
Yeah.
In terms of this game, how important is it therefore that goal line technology will be at St Mary's Stadium?
Oh, it's absolutely fantastic, as you say. We'd never have the level of media coverage that we've had on this occasion for a cup final, and we probably never will get this again in the future. All eyes are on the Hampshire FA Senior Cup Final. I think it makes it that much more special for the players and the match officials involved. And we're really, really pleased to have the FIFA guys down testing it, really. It'd be an excellent, excellent afternoon and evening, I would think.
Yeah, and of course, two great non-league football teams from Hampshire, obviously AFC Totton and Eastleigh, vying it out for a place of silverware. Out of the two teams, you couldn't have picked a better final in terms of the competition. Obviously, Basingstoke are out. They're obviously in a higher position than Eastleigh. But would you agree with me saying that Eastleigh and AFC Totton fighting is probably the best final you could have hoped for?
It's certainly one of the best we could have hoped for. I mean, there are a number of really good teams that enter the competition. And it would be unfair of me to start singling particular teams out as being better than others, but it will be a great final. AFC Totton have had a fantastic season. Eastleigh probably not done as well as they would have liked. Both teams will probably be playing Conference South football at some stage in the next few seasons. And they'll be battling out in the league as well as in the cup, so it should be a really good final.
And of course, the final being at St Mary's Stadium. Southampton have done brilliantly in the Championship this year. They got promoted. How important is it to have it at such a world-class facility as Southampton, of course, in the Premiership?
Absolutely. It's undoubtedly the best facility that we've got in the county. And it's fantastic that the best non-league game of football in the area is going to be played at the best stadium. It's, you know, we're really grateful to Southampton Football Club for hosting us again for another year.
Well, Dan, we've spoken about goal line technology being there. What is actually the technology behind this groundbreaking kind of technology?
Well, at the moment, FIFA are testing two systems. The system we're testing at St Mary's Stadium is Hawkeye, which you probably will have heard from tennis and cricket. Similar kind of system. They're going to put seven cameras at each end of the ground, and they'll be mounted on the roof. They're very small, so you probably wouldn't even notice them. And what they're going to do is they're going to build that up into a picture, all behind the scenes, mapping where the football is, if you like. And then that will relay to the referee instantly if there's a goal line decision to be made. So within 2 or 3 seconds of a goal line incident, the referee will have a signal on his watch which says goal or no goal. And all that technology just is sort of dealt with out the back. So.
Very important. I suppose as well, like we've spoken of Frank Lampard's goal in World Cup 2010 with the goal it should have been. Even a couple of weeks ago in the Premiership, the goal from QPR, that wasn't given.
Yeah.
And of course, fortunately for them, they stayed up. Will it actually be tested? You've said it will be tested, but will the referee be able to overrule any situation, or is it just to be tested for technological purposes?
In tomorrow night's match, it will only be the observers in the ground from FIFA who will be have access, if you like, to the system. The referee will have no idea whether the technology says it's a goal or not, and that's important really to maintain everything that's gone on in the competition so far. We don't anticipate bringing goal line technology into the Senior Cup anytime soon,
no.
But it you know, I think that's really important that actually this is just a test.
Yeah, is this a start as well? Is it just goal line technology, or will there be like for offsides later on in the future? Is this sort of like a build up to something bigger?
Certainly something that FIFA will have to have a debate on, and I'm sure there will be a debate. I think it goes around a philosophical issue, really. This technology is excellent because it won't require any starting or stopping of the game, because the referee will get it instantly. Mm. And it's over a matter of fact, did the ball cross the line or not? It either has or it hasn't. Mm-hmm. There's no opinion there. Whereas for free kicks or whether someone's interfered with play for offside, we then bring in opinion, and there's a whole philosophical debate, I think, to have. So don't expect other technology to come flying in straight away. Yeah. There is that philosophical debate to have, and we will see.
Well, it's not only the philosophical debate, it's obviously the money as well. Like, absolutely, at the end of the day, the Premiership could probably afford goal line technology, but for non-league football, there's that money, isn't there? There's no money in there at all. My next question would be regarding the media. You know, yourself being a big media man for Hampshire FA, you've obviously been inundated with inquiries and interviews with the cup final in regards to goal line technology. Like, who have you spoken to?
Oh, well, it's been fantastic, really. We've had last week I was doing an interview with TalkSport, which was fantastic. We've had Sky Sports News, we've had BBC, we've had ITV, CNN, some of the big national newspapers from around the world, from the States, from Brazil. It's been a worldwide event this year, which is something it will probably never be in the future, but it's fantastic for us.
OK, what's that question again? Who do you think will win it? AFC Totton or Eastleigh? Come on, you've got to give me an answer.
I'm not going to give you one.
Why not?
Because okay. I'm perfectly impartial.
Well, there you go. Well, Dan's excited. I think everyone here is excited. It's the Hampshire Senior Cup Final. Eastleigh against AFC Totton. Who will take this trophy home? OK, that was Dan Berry there from Hampshire FA. The big talk of this final is on goal line technology, which finally makes its appearance. Now, how significant is this for a cup final, especially non-league football at St Mary's Stadium?
Well, I think it's a fantastic development for football, for the game as a whole, from on the world and international stage, Aaron. Obviously, this is something FIFA have been needing for a little while now, and hopefully the implementation of this technology means that, you know, we're not going to have so many goal line sort of issues and contentious decisions anymore in future. I think it's only a positive for the sport.
Yep, and of course, talking of Southampton Football Club, there's no greater place in Hampshire, especially non-league football, to be playing at now a Premiership Football Club's ground.
Well, exactly, and I'm sure both the players of AFC Totton and Eastleigh will both be delighted at playing, as you say, at a ground that's going to be featuring in the Premier League next season. So this is going to be a real honour for these two teams, and you know, almost as much as an honour as lifting that trophy itself, Aaron.
Well, so here we go then. It's Hampshire Senior Cup Final 2012. Who will win, Eastleigh or AFC Totton? Joining me at St Mary's in the commentary box is Jake Gable. Hampshire Senior Cup Final 2012. Eastleigh against AFC Totton. Last silverware is up for grabs here.
Both sides would like to play attacking football, Aaron. Both sides would like to get it down on the deck. We should be in for an interesting game here.
Let's have a look at this Eastleigh lineup then, Jake. Barford in goal, Nelson, Green, Forbes, Jordan, Elphick, Flood, Holloway, Brown, McMahon and Scannell. AFC Totton then, Porter in goal, Ryan Hill right back, Callum Davies, Ian Richardson, Scott, Coots, Pettifer, Jonathan Davies, Sherbourne, Charles and Brown. 22 men on the pitch, 90 minutes separate the victor and the loser of the Hampshire Senior Cup Final 2012 begins now, and immediately with AFC Totton, the Wolves play back in defence, shooting from left to right in their yellow strip, Eastleigh in the blue. It's going to be an exciting game, Jake Gable.
Absolutely, Aaron. Could be in for some goals, and oh, we nearly had an early one there.
Absolutely, yeah, it was a shot there on the edge of the area. But looks like the AFC Totton there. Porter was aware for that one and straight away boots the ball upfield. Interesting to see. AFC Totton, remember, have won this tournament two times on the bounce. Consecutive years, they're going for the treble. Eastleigh have never played in the Hampshire Senior Cup Final.
Well, it'll be their job to stop them this evening, Aaron.
Oh, that's a heavy challenge already. And it goes for a throw-in. It's going out for an AFC Totten throw-in. It's going to be taken there by the number six, James Coots. It's going to leave it for Ryan Hill to take. Here is Coots. Here's Hill. Nice triangle football and a sturdy challenge there on Jonathan Davies, but the referee allows play to continue. So we Hill again. And it's just gone all the way for a goal kick. So we see a pressing forward here, and on this near side now for Green, for Eastleigh. Flicks the ball over, headed away, and Hill there, and he goes down, and it's going to be a free kick. So Lima, who's obviously seen the two sturdy challenges already, and is telling Hill just to calm down.
Well, Hill didn't look too pleased there, Aarran.
Here we go again with Eastleigh. Players calling for the ball on the far side. Holloway over to Mitchell Nelson in the colourful red boots. Now here we go, here's Nelson on the far side. Pulls it back there to one of the players. It goes into the... Oh, and a chance
wide
there from for Jamie Brown. So the real first effort for both sides falls to Jamie Brown, the number nine for Eastleigh. Here we go, Mitchell Nelson again. It's going to be a fascinating battle on that right-hand side of midfield. And he wins the throw-in, Jake.
Well, he's going to have to be watching Nelson, Aarran. He's fast and electric and very direct, and they're going to have to do well to deal with him down that right-hand flank tonight.
Yeah, well, Mitchell Nelson will take this throw-in. It's going to be another trademark long throw-in then from the right midfielder. In it goes. Oh, and the flick on so nearly. Well, the goalkeeper, well, this is Elphick. Eastleigh happy to build up from the back. Holloway over to the captain, Jordan. Nelson. I'm just checking his run in my
eye line. Well, he's run, Aarran, he's through.
And he's going through here. Has he got it? Has he got the pace on him? Yes, he has. He's beaten Davies. He squares the ball. It's a great chance for Eastleigh. And that is the opening goal of the Hampshire Senior Cup Final 2012. Chris Flood opens the scoring. Brilliant worked goal from Eastleigh.
Well, it's absolutely fantastic work there. Mitchell Nelson, we mentioned him earlier, Aarran, going down the right-hand side, and we said they'd have to pick him up, and they didn't. It was Callum Davis from Totton who let him go. Nelson there just bundling the ball across, and, well, it was very close, but there you have it. Eastleigh lead, Aarran.
Yeah, and the two defenders couldn't stop the ball from going into the back of the net. So there you have it. Eastleigh lead by Golton against AFC Totton. Replay coming in again, and, well, he did very well there to slide in.
It's a good finish.
Sure, that's a good start there for Sean Wilkinson. And there you have it. The first goal scorer, Chris Flood for Eastleigh. Well, AFC Totton will be wanting to get the ball upfield as much as possible. It's going to contend with a free kick here, and it's floated in. And chance missed by Eastleigh.
Wow, that really was a golden chance, Aarran. Should have done better there. That was a free header. And how costly could that prove for Eastleigh later on in this game?
Unbelievable opportunity. And the goalkeeper flapped and, well,
there you see it.
Got away with that one. Nelson again, into the box it goes, headed away. It's going to fall now to Jonathan Davies. He's done brilliantly here with a lovely bit of skill, and he's still going.
Oh, that's fantastic.
That's a lovely skill. And he's still running here. It's four against four here. Gets down. What's the referee given here? He's played on.
No, he's given nothing. Went down a little bit easily there for me, Davies.
Well, we'll see that one in the replay in a moment. But as Eastleigh counter-attack here with Chris Flood, the goal scorer, with his bit of skill here, and wins the throw-in there of Callum Davies. No relation, of course.
Well, he's having a word, Aarran, and doesn't seem pleased with that, the ref. Just left a leg dangling here. Here we see it.
Yeah, yep. Training leg, his right leg there, and immediately the referee played it on.
That's a soft one.
But I wonder what he'll be thinking. Oh, it's a good ball onto this far side, but should be dealt comfortably, but it's not. And it's a mix-up between goalkeeper and defender. And it's eventually cleared. But Eastleigh really, really... And the ball eventually is away. Oh, and slipped away, and now Eastleigh has the opportunity. And this is Scannell. In it goes. Up towards Mitchell Nelson, lovely contrast on the control, and the shot from Nelson is high, wide, and not very handsome. So it's going to be a corner on this far side. It's going to be taken by McNahan. Players are arriving in the box. Looks like Scannell's just dropped out on the outside. The goalkeeper comes out, punches a clear away. But still Eastleigh are in the box. Lots of people in there. McNahan again. This time it's cleared away. The shot comes in, the drive. This is out, and here we go now. It's three against three.
Well, they've got men over, Aarran.
This is a great opportunity for AFC Totton, and he's been put through here. It's a great chance for
1-1. Oh!
And he's put it wide.
Wow, dearie me. Sherborne there, and he was one-on-one, Aarran, and he really should have done better. Just seemed to flap at it. And how pivotal could that be going into half-time?
Michael Green there, chasing him back. He may well have put Shambourne off. Here come Eastleigh again, and Nelson's just making the run onto the far side. Here he is again. Swings the ball into the box, headed away by Hill. And still not cleared. And now here with AFC Totton again with Shambourne. And that's a fine ball onto this far side. And it's a chase here. And Charles has got the ball here. Pulls it back to Davies. Back to Charles. Gets the shot away, and it's a tame effort. That's another corner. And it's going to be Mattingham to take it on this near side. Nice little floating ball into the box. The goalkeeper came out, rather flapped at it, and no one knows where the ball is. It's all very scrappy. Oh, that's good skill. He didn't go down. The ball's played in. The goalkeeper tries to get the ball again and wins the free kick.
Well, there was a chance. Grant Porter under pressure there, and he looked far from convincing.
Well, half-time here. Eastleigh 1, AFC Totton 0.
Yeah, Eastleigh deserving the lead there at half-time, and I'm sure Jim Thorne will be having words with his players there. It'll be interesting to see how the second half pans out.
Here we go, Eastleigh then, shooting from left to right in this second half. That one goal advantage of 45 minutes away from Hampshire Senior Cup glory for the first time in their history. And straight away, Jordan upfield. And the pass from the hand up there from Scannell, an appreciation of the ball. It was a long route one ball there from the captain. But Porter there collected it well, and he will know that these 45 minutes are important as he boots the ball as far forward as he possibly can. This is Coutts. Davies. He's got Hill just running off him here. And Hill, that's a strong challenge by Michael Green. And
hello. Oh, wow, there's handbags.
Yeah, the referee may have to get involved here pretty quickly because both players are certainly at each other.
And they're all getting involved, Aarran. This is not good to see.
Yeah, and Ryan Hill and, the crowd.
The ref's reaching for his pocket.
Wants one of these players to be sent off, and Lymal has got a big call to make here. It looks like Hill's shirt's been ripped.
Looks like yellows for both, but
well,
both
Green
men
is the
there.
First one in the book. Yeah. He is going to be yellow carded, so Michael Green is in the book, and the crowd are shouting off for Ryan Hill. But I'm sure if he got a yellow, Ryan Hill,
yellow for Hill as well, Aarran.
Yellow. Well, Hill had to change into the number 17 shirt, and he's got a free kick here. Perfect position, a four-man wall. It's like Barfoot. It's just pushed him over a little bit further. The shotgun was deflected, and it's just fizzed over the post.
That's not far away. That is not far away, Aarran. There's a couple of inches in that.
That would have gone in had it not have gone a deflection. Here come AFC Totton again on the ball. A bit scrappy on this near side. It's still on. The referee's allowed play to continue. It's still with Michael Charles. And he cuts inside. Tried to get the dummy. And still they chase. And it's Jonathan Davies. And that could go anywhere. Oh, and tipped over.
Well, it was great work in the build-up there from Charles. Industrious, kept hold of the ball well. And gave his team that opportunity.
Here comes the corner. And claimed by Barfoot. It's going to be a free kick. Hill's going to take this one. Five up. Onto the far side it goes. Oh, it's escaped everyone! Oh, and a glorious chance spurned there from James Coutts.
Well, how on earth did that manage to get in that far? I do not know, Aarran. In swinging free kick. Here we see it. And it's just left completely by the defence. Totton with a great chance, and it's just not buried.
Well, I'm sure both managers can't complain about the chances they've had in this second half. But here we go again with AFC Totton. They've certainly played better in this second half. Now onto this far side. It's a lovely 1-2. It's a lovely chance. Oh, deflected post. Second chance. It hits the post again. Jonathan Davies.
Well, it's that man Davies again causing problems. Charging forward. A great give and go. Fantastic work from him. And he's unlucky there.
Oh, goodness me. And again, had it not been deflected, Jake, I'm pretty sure that would have hit the back of the net.
Yeah, we see it, yeah.
Oh, goodness me. Still 1-0 Eastleigh, and I think the defence is just, yes. Let's see, it might be an introduction here in any moment.
Well, time ticking out now, Aarran, for Totton. They're going to have to get this forward quite quickly.
Callum Davies, and this is Pettifer. As he tosses in, and that was Coots who went down. And want to get the ball played straight away. But no, the referee's going to stop them. I think it's going to be a substitution there is. And it looks like Scott Rogers is coming on for Damien Scannell. Scannell's had a good game.
Yeah, he's worked very hard down that flank for Eastleigh.
And I think Eastleigh are going to make a like-for-like swap. AFC Totton on the ball again. This is Pettifer. Headed away, but back to Pettifer. You know, AFC Totton are just moving forward, inch by inch, every minute by minute. And that's lovely score again by Davies, and he's still going.
Oh.
That's lovely work here. He checks and turns, he gets the shot away, and in the end, it didn't quite fall for him. But it's a lovely bit of work there from Jonathan Davies. We see on the replay again, straight at the goalkeeper, but the wonderful audacity and of the skill and of the shot in itself.
Well, he's
brilliant.
Really playing himself towards that man of the match award, Aarran.
Long thrown into the box, headed away. Oh, pulls on the trap by Magnum. Oh, it got headed on the way through in the second chance. Oh!
Shades of Gascoigne Euro 96 there, Aarran. A matter of inches away. Madness. Wow.
We'll see that one in a moment, but in the meantime, AFC Totten have the counter-attack, and straight away, with Davies again, he's going to try and set up a ball up here. He's got Hill, who's come forward, and still with Davies. And wins the throw-in. But let's have a look back on this one. The volley came in from Attenham, and it came off the head.
It's palmed away, wow.
And we'll get back to that one in a moment, Jake, because the long throw-in into the box it comes, and the goalkeeper comes up, and it's going to be a free kick. For Eastleigh, with Michael Charles just pushing Barfoot there. But goodness me, all he needed to do was connect with this ball on the line. Here we go again.
Oh,
goodness me.
Well, he's a matter of inches away there from Hampshire Senior Cup glory, Aarran.
Jamie Brown could and probably should have scored the second. Here's Mattenham again.
Well, one goal would win it now for Eastleigh.
And here's the man to set the wall up. Here's Chris Flood. And it looks like... Mitchell Nelson's making a run into the far post. He's got a great chance for two.
He's free.
It's over the line. It's over the line. It's definitely over the line. And Eastleigh has scored the second goal of this cup final and now lead AFC Totton by 2-0. And is that game over, Jake Gable?
I think it is, Aarran. There you have it. I said in the build-up, one goal would win it now for Eastleigh. They've charged forward. It's a great counter-attack. Ball played out. And it's that man, Mitchell Nelson, again, left unmarked at the far post. Here we see it coming in. Just bundling the ball home from close range there, and he really should be being picked up by his marker. But is that the goal that's given Eastleigh Hampshire Senior Cup glory?
No question about it. It definitely crossed the line, and Grant Porter there. It's a good free kick to Eastleigh. Chance, oh, on the fund. Well, that pretty much sums up AFC Totton, but they don't care, do Eastleigh. 2-0 to the good. Eastleigh still not content to sit on their laurels and rest with a 2-0 lead. Pulls it back to Mattenhunt. Oh, the ball onto this far side. Jackson turns, gets the drive away. It's a good save there from Porter. And the second ball comes into the box and Porter gets down low for that one. But it was a good save there from the AFC Totton there from a stunning drive. But it's a beautiful night here at St Mary's as the sun sets. Maybe a 30,000 seater stadium, but a good 2,000 fans from AFC Totton and Eastleigh have descended here in Southampton for what has been a fascinating cup game.
Could be about to get a whole lot more beautiful for Eastleigh, Aarran.
Well, Mitchell Andy just couldn't quite keep it in. Here come AFC Totton, what have they got in here? And oh, and the goalkeeper's backtracking here and he had to clear that ball away. And still Eastleigh will keep on coming. And AFC Totton defending stoically there. And now here comes...
Well, they need a goal.
So he's been brought down. And there could be a card here for Tom Jordan. The referee lineman's got his cards out. But again, look at the shot there. Picturesque at St Mary's Stadium. And it's going to be the captain, Tom Jordan, for Eastleigh. He's going to find himself a name in the book. And the party is already starting in Eastleigh. It's going to be a free kick here. Hill will take it. Well, he already had one in earlier on in this second half.
This has to go in, Aarran. No doubts about it now for Totton. They need this goal.
Three-man wall. Here it comes. It is a shot, and it's straight into the arms of Barfoot. A lot of people here at St Mary's Stadium. That was a quick shot there of Dan Berry there. The ball's played back here, and Eastleigh have won the Hampshire Senior Cup Final for the first time in their history. And modest handshakes all round.
Yeah, absolutely. Congratulations to Eastleigh. They've deserved it tonight. Played well, kept the ball, got the ball forward quickly. They've been great going forward.
And spare a thought for AFC Totton. They've played their part here in this final.
Wow, these players have given it all. I don't think Jim Thorne can have any complaints about that.
And Eastleigh. The party in Eastleigh and the party in St Mary's has already started. And here is the top goal scorer of the competition, the Hampshire Senior Cup Final. Wearing a very elaborate, very shiny suit, I must say.
Somewhat similar to the one you're sporting in the commentary box tonight, Aaron.
And the referee, Colin Lima, his assistants Wayne Thomas and Craig Burton, the reserve official, Morris Taylor, picking up their awards. They've all had a good game tonight, Jake.
Yeah, absolutely. Done very well. No major contentious issues, but I think they've had it right when they've needed to.
And the top gun and the man of the match, Mitchell Nelson. There's the AFC Totton players come and collect their runners-up medals.
Well, none of those players will want to be getting one of those medals, Aaron. You know, they've come this far. They want to win it now. But it just wasn't to be for them tonight.
Worthy runners-up, though, as Eastleigh collect those, their medals. It's Mitchell Nelson there collecting his. That's Elphick. Gary Holloway behind him. And so on. And as soon as the captain, Tom Jordan, raises the trophy, that means that Eastleigh will be the champions of the Hampshire Senior Cup. They've finally knocked AFC Totton off the perch. They have won the trophy twice before in two consecutive seasons with some brilliant football. And as the crowd roar with expectation, I'm sure Tom Jordan will duly deliver. Eastleigh are the champions of the Hampshire Senior Cup.
Well, they've played well throughout. They've deserved it, and I'm sure the party will be going on in Eastleigh long into the night. Terrific scenes here.
There you have it. Eastleigh have beaten AFC Totton by 2-0. Well, there you have it. Eastleigh have won the 2012 Hampshire Senior Cup Final by beating AFC Totton by 2-0. Now I'm joined here by Jake, who was alongside me with me at the game. Now let's talk about the post-match analysis here. There was one nice little battle on the right-hand side of midfield for Eastleigh that really kind of excited me.
Yes.
Let's talk about this.
Absolutely. Well, it was the battle between Mitchell Nelson on the right-hand side for Eastleigh, Callum Davis on the left for Totton. And let's just pick up the action here and see. This is the opening goal. Now, you're about to see Nelson, the right-back, coming into your shot now. There he is in the red boots. Now plays it forward. Now Callum Davis, the left back here, really should be keeping track of Nelson, but the ball's played in over the top. As you see, it's a very good ball. Nelson keeps his pace, keeps his strength, plays the ball across goal, and it's bundled home. Now for me, Callum Davis there, the Totten left back, he should really be keeping tabs on Nelson, but Nelson's pushing him back into his own half and he can't get out.
To be fair on Davis, do you think that was a foul on the edge of the area?
No, Aaron, I think he should be standing up there and making himself count.
Now, okay, what about this man here then?
Well, it was a tale of two Davies really for AFC Totton. Obviously Callum the left back, but this boy here, Jonathan Davis, impressed me throughout the whole game. He's got touch, technique, pace, awareness. Look at him go. He's the creative hub for them. Now, I'm just going to take this action here and stop it just there. Now, if we wait for the pass to come through here, here it comes, perfectly weighted ball through to Nathaniel Sherborne, and this was a turning point because Sherborne's fired wide, and if he puts that one in on the stroke of half-time, it's 1-1 going in at the break, and that's a massive psychological difference, I think, for AFC Totton.
And of course, they didn't score 1-0 at the break, but they kept trying, didn't they? And this man here was the centre of everything for AFC Totton.
Absolutely. It's Davis again. Lovely touch. He's got skills, bags of ability, and here you see him testing the keeper with a nice shot. And Totten coming forward, and they seem to impress me on the counter-attack when they got the ball forward quickly. Ball to Davis again, the quick give and go. deflected shot, and he's in again. He's a live wire, and he caused problems for the Eastleigh defence all afternoon long, Aaron.
Yep, and no matter what Davies did, he didn't score, but Eastleigh got their second goal, and that pretty much killed the tie-off, didn't it?
They did indeed, and it's that man, Nowson, coming in again at the bottom of your picture in the red boots. Keep an eye on him. There's the number three for Totten, Davies. Not keeping an eye on Nowson again. Nowson's free at the back post, and it's bundled home, 2-0 to Eastleigh, and that's game over. And at that level, I think Callum Davies should really be doing a lot better. But hats off to Mitchell Nowson. He's my man of the match for that. You know, absolutely electric all game long, Aaron, down that right-hand side for Eastleigh.
Yeah, well, of course, with goal line technology being at St Mary's as well. From where we were standing, it was definitely a goal. But there was probably a few people on the other side who probably thought they didn't cross the line.
Well, it seemed to be, you know, over the line, but it's just as well that they had this technology, you know, being displayed at the match tonight, because, you know, it was a little bit of a risky one at one point.
Now, enough of the nice stuff, the bad stuff. 47th minute, there was a fight. Talk us through this one.
Absolutely. Well, it involves Ryan Hill and Michael Green, and it's just handbags at 10 paces, really, Aaron. You know, it's this ugly side of football that we don't want to see. Both guys here issued with a yellow card by the ref, but it could have been a lot worse, and they both could have let their sides down in what's, you know, obviously such an important fixture for both the two teams. It's silly, and, you know, it's not what we like to see in football. It's not. It's the ugly side of the beautiful game, really. Oh.
Jake, thank you very much for joining us.
No worries.
Yeah, well, there you go. Well, that's it for Winnell this footballing season. And what a way to bow out. But remember, you can continue to watch award-winning news, sport and features by logging onto winnell.co.uk. But from Jake and myself, it's goodbye.